book. I've been here for quite some time with ARP and other groups. Few points which came to my mind after this incident, what happened. And actually, to say that that incident is unfortunate, or I mean, that's, we all know, that's why we all are here. So I don't want to go into what happened, because it happened, it has been happening for years and years. It's just that sometimes something happens and it triggers a movement across the country and across, because of the media, across the world, wherever we live. So that's what has happened, in my opinion, with this young boy's suicide. But having said that, and I understand the pain of a Dalit, because if somebody discriminates on the name of caste or anything like that, for any reason, how you have to go through the ordeal. And if you know, in from a reality, like irrespective of which town or city we come from, I don't know not much about cities, but definitely in towns and small towns, there's a separate area where Dalits live. There's a separate area where Muslims live. So I'm already like kind of, you know, walled from this. I will never know the misery of yours, and you will never know the luxury of mine. So there is no counter. There is no dealing with each other. I think that is where the main problem is. I only know about Muslim what the narrative comes to me. I only know about Dalit what the narrative is coming to me, and which always negative, because that makes me feel good. Everybody is a problem except myself, because I'm always born good. So interaction between the communities has not increased, irrespective of what we call about the media or this age. If one thing that can happen with this outrage also, what I'm seeing is, which I will come to the few points which we may agree or not agree, is there nobody is talking about the interaction between the communities. And that is exactly where I was thinking what Gandhiji would have done. This, after this whole Rohit's story, Ambedkarism has kicked in, and somewhere Ambedkarism has been put as a counter to Gandhism. You know, you are Anant Murthy, when he said something about the Modi government, and then, you know, how he was countered. He said a very good sentence, which I remember was, he said, in this country, only you can talk bad about Gandhi and be away from it, get away with it. You cannot talk about any other leader. So what is happening is, on the name of Ambedkarism, it is becoming very revengeful. The language on the name of Rohit is becoming very revengeful. As a Hindu, I want revenge from Muslim. Dalit want revenge from me. So I have a problem with this revengeful attitude. If you want to create an equitable society, you cannot take revenge against me. It's not my fault. Yes, I got the privilege, because of that I should be ashamed of it. I'm ashamed of a lot of things my forefathers did, and I'm ready to change it. But being revengeful, I don't know where we will go from here. And how this revengeful on the name of Dalitism is different from Brahmanism. Actually, Dalits are becoming neo-Brahmins. In a lot of sense, those who have become multi-millionaires, they don't want to talk about their own people. So this narrative, we should be careful in taking it towards the revengeful attitude. I give you an example of that, you know, the symbolism which is going around on social media of a Brahmin with the choti, and you know, that Dalit, the Rohit is kind of hanged with it. Why we always need a villain? The villain is within us, it's in everybody. It's every one of us, the villain. You don't need to, you know, put a Brahmin as something. Brahmin has their own problem. So that's where I'm coming from, that it should not, the narrative should not become revengeful. It should not become this versus that, like Gandhism versus Ambedkarism. And that is where it is going to, as if like, okay, if something happened, and another thing, compartmentalization. Now Rohit happened, there will be a particular kind of people, they will raise the issue. If there is something else with, somebody says something like Amir Khan, then there will be a particular kind of people, they will raise Amir Khan issue. That's not my issue. So, you know, the compartmentalization of issues is also happening, and according to the ideology. So ideological ghettos on the name of persons and tragedies. That has to be really avoided if really Dalits want to create an equitable society. then first of all you should demonstrate that you want an equitable society, not a revenge. That's one thing. Another the point I will finish very fast is which revenge is going on the name of Hinduism also. All the narrative is why always in the arena of Hinduism. What if this thing would have happened with a Muslim, then we should have raised the same issue. And we should. Don't take me on the other side. We are saying we should. If we talk about caste-free society, outcast the caste, then we should be talking about everything. Not just few things here and there. And that's what we should strive for. That's another point. Why always the conversation is between the arena of Hinduism only? Why only Hinduism has to reform? Now, don't take me on that side. I'm not saying Hinduism doesn't have to reform. Actually, it has to reform more to lead. Because it is the main religion, main system. It has to show by example. I should be more compassionate and open about everything else, rather than comparing with others, not using the counter argument. Just because some other society is closed, then I should be closed too. I'm not saying that. Actually, I should be leading more. Third one, I want to say that what I am seeing more and more is ideologies are moving away from humanism. And I'm sorry, but I don't want to be a part of any ideology which has moved away from humanism. You know, it doesn't matter which ideology you belong to, which color ka jhanda you have, it doesn't matter. What matters is my ideology should be aligned with humanism. And if it is not, then I have a problem within me. And that is another thing which is happening with this so-called Ambedkarism and Dalitism and this and that. Why you want to take to a point where it just looks like I just want to burn everything. Varnaism and last point I want to say, Varna and caste, what Manusmriti he was mentioning, Akshay bhai. See, casteism and Varnism, what has happened was, in my opinion, that was a flat thing and with the compartments. It's like this room, you create four rooms in it. And they made a ladder out of it because it works for them. So there was a ladder that was lying down with four steps. They put it like this and then somebody said on the top, hey, it's me. And now everybody is coming down and you are this. So everything gets junked no matter how good it is created. I'm not saying Manusmriti is good or bad. That can be discussed. But what I'm saying is every system gets misused. Parasites come into the system to use the system. So we have to fight the parasite. Are we fighting the parasite? Or are we fighting the system itself? I don't know what we are trying to do. What I am seeing is just destroy everything without knowing what we have to create. What my feeling is that Hinduism has become like an old palace. You know, you go and visit, see it. It doesn't have any relevance today. But we don't know what to create new. So that's where my scare, I'm really scared, is you're destroying everything without knowing what to create. On the name of equitability, are you creating a chaos? The same thing happened with the woman liberation. On the name of woman liberation, what has happened is most of the cases of divorce has increased, and I am seeing more and more it's the woman who is demanding. So the independentism has become more to break the society, break the family. And it has its own repercussions. I'm not saying it's good or bad, who knows what. I'm saying it has its own repercussions. Western society has its own repercussions. So, one last point is, I think this is not to do with caste or anything. What I feel is the Indian society lacks the dignity of labor. Why the people who pick up my garbage in every damn city in India are from a particular caste? And it's not about picking the garbage, the problem is with the level. These are like low level people who pick up the garbage. If you make the respect for the labor, then this whole thing will disappear itself. Because society, like it or not, has moved away from religion, caste, and people are, everybody's busy making money these days. You know, caste has become a caste. I don't want to marry my daughter to anybody of my caste who is much poorer than me. But I will marry to somebody who is Dalit's son, but if he is a multi-millionaire. So class has become new caste. Caste is outfading. But then again, your caste is going, the name is changing, it is not a free flow anymore. We are becoming more again ideologically constrained. So humanism and dignity of labor, I think, is the main points which where we should be focusing, rather than demonizing the Brahmin and being Brahmin demonizing something else. That's where my points were. Thank you.
Thank you.